Welcome back to my learnings channel. In this video we are going to learn about Docker networking. In the modern application development approaches, many organizations are following microservice architecture style. Here I've taken one such example, where we can have n number of back-end microservices based on different functionalities, and back-end applications are connecting to single DB instance, and also back-end applications are communicating with each other. The front-end application can only communicate with respective back-end application, based on user interaction with the UI elements. For better understanding, if you visualize shopping cart application, where identity service exists for authentication and authorization, and inventory service exists for listing out available stock, and order management system for accepting orders. Once order has confirmed by the system, the same information notified to packing and tracking applications to initiate next further activities. Now the question is, if these microservices are deployed in Docker environment, then what are the possible network options we can go for? If all these containers installed in single Docker host, as a standalone instance, then what can be the right network option? Or if these containers are installed in multiple Docker hosts, then what can be the right network option? And also back-end application should only accept calls which are from UI application, so then what are the rules need to inject into to the firewalls? In the same way DB should accept connection requests which are from back-end applications, then how to alert IPtable rules accordingly? Or can we achieve without alerting IPtables itself? To get answers for all these questions, first we've to get familiar with Docker networking terminology. What are the Docker in-built network options? Once you install Docker in your PC, it come up with three network options. Bridge network, host and none. The scope of a bridge network is within the Docker host itself, which means containers which are deployed in Docker host can only communicate with each other. These containers cannot connect to other containers which are running in different host. Host network is an option to bypass network isolation for a container, which means container installed with other isolations like storage, RAM and processing. The running container with host uses different namespaces other than network namespace. None is an option to disable network for a container. Some containers doesn't require any network interaction where independent computations exists. But these three options doesn't solve most of the real use cases, so Docker supports other network options as well. Those are overlay network, MacVLAN and some third-party network plugins as well. Now let us start with how Docker achieved this network isolation. To understand Docker network isolation, first we need get some knowledge on IPtables. IPtables is a standard firewall included in most of the Linux distributions by default. Setting up a good firewall is an essential step for any operating system, otherwise hackers can hit your containers if those are exposed to public without any reason. Whatever the reason behind hacking, but they can corrupt your system through injections and they just increase the load on system. So firewalls are very important to system which are open to public. Basically it shouldn't be free entry to a party without any invitation. So now let us take a look how IPtables works. IPtables firewall works by comparing incoming and outgoing network traffic against a set of rules. There are many options to establish which packets match a specific rule. When any network packet matches with defined pattern, then the action takes place is called a target. A target can be a final policy decision for the matched packet, such as accept or drop. It can also be move the packet to a different chain for processing. These rules organized into groups called chains. A chain is a set of rules that a packet is checked sequentially. Once a packet matches with one of the rules, it executes associated action that can be either drop or accept, and it will not check with remaining rules in the chain. By default, IPtable come up with three chains: input, output and forward chain. Input chain handles all packets that are addressed to your server. Output chain contains rules for traffic created by your server. Forward chain is for routing requests to other machines. Let us understand how Docker is modifying IPtables to achieve network isolation. Docker installs two custom chains, those are Docker chain and Docker user chain. To achieve network isolation, all of Docker's IPtables rules are added to the Docker chain, and we shouldn't modify these rules in any case. Just one point to remember, that is, we can change Docker daemon instance configuration to disable IPtables. Just need to add a IPtable flag to false, but we may encounter some network-related errors. If you want to add any rules, those need to be considered before Docker rules, then weave to add those in Docker user chain. Have a look on below specified commands, where I've added rules into Docker user chain only to consider requests, which are from specific IP address, any other network connections will be rejected instantly. In the same way I've specified range of IP addresses, if the incoming packet IP address not within the given range then that request is going to drop. This is one of the way to protect your container from anonymous calls. In some cases if we know the source and target systems, then only containers should accept incoming requests. And one more point to remember, these IPtables are input to kernel level net filter to manipulate network stack. And in the latest Linux distributions NFTables came into picture. If you are targeting for Docker administration, you must familiar with netfilter, IPtables and NFTables. So far we understood, what is IPtable, and how Docker modifying those to achieve network isolation. Now let us take a look into Docker network options. The first one, Docker's default bridge network. By default if you don't specify any network option, while starting a container, then Docker attaches default bridge network to it. The scope of a bridge network is within the Docker host itself, which means containers which are deployed in same Docker host can only communicate with each other, these containers cannot connect to other containers which are in different host. To achieve default bridge network, Docker uses software bridge, it creates virtual IP address to each container, one container can communicate with other container using these internal IP addresses. One thing we've to remember that, default bridge network we shouldn't use in production, because there is no control in connectivity among containers, which are connected to default bridge network. Instead we can go for, user-defined bridge network in production. User-defined bridges provide automatic DNS resolution between containers, so a container can reach other container using its name. It provides better isolation than default bridge, and containers can be attached and detached from user-defined networks on the fly, we need not to bring down the container, and each user-defined network creates a configurable bridge. And container service name is always constant but not virtual IP address. Here I've created one user-defined bridge network, using Docker network create command, and the same will be available for usage in the Docker network stack. We can attach a configured network to a container, by using docker run command with network option. And we can remove a configured network, only if no running containers exists with same user-defined network. And the second network option, that is host network, which means no network isolation, and there will not be any virtual IP address exists for a container, which is running with host network. And host network option only available for Linux machine, this network option doesn't work for Mac and Windows. Host mode networking can be useful to optimize performance, where a container needs to handle a large range of ports, as it does not require network address translation. The third one overlay network, or a multi-host network option. The overlay network driver creates a distributed network among multiple Docker daemon hosts. And it runs on top of the host-specific networks. Basically this network option enables the container's communication, which are in different hosts. To test this network, either we can go with two VM instances in one PC, or two laptops with Linux operation system. And here we need to use Docker Swarm, even for standalone containers, which creates a cluster, by adding set of nodes into a group. The node, where you initialize Docker Swarm in it, is going to be manager node, remain all the work nodes. Once you initialize the Docker Swarm in one of the node, it will internally create two networks, a bridge network called Docker Gateway Bridge, which connects the individual Docker daemon, to the other daemons participating in the Swarm, an overlay network called Ingress, which handles the control and data traffic related to Swarm services. And one thing to remember, if you understand the Docker Swarm concept correctly, then understanding Kubernetes architecture becomes easy. If you want to establish a Docker native cluster, by using Docker Swarm service, then make sure below specified ports are available to use, and are open to connect. I've executed Docker Swarm init in my machine, if you want to add any Docker host to the group, then we need to run swarm join command in other node, and if you've look into the available networks, you may notice two additional networks got added to the network stack. Here, I've compared some multi-host network plugins. Those are Calico, Flannel, Weave and Docker's Overlay Network. If you want to be a champion in network configuration, then you must be familiar with internals. Now let us start the actual fun part, that is demo part. In the demo, every time I start two containers, to establish connectivity between those two containers, by using different network options. And I'm going to start a demo in my MacBook, so I can able to demonstrate very few network options. Those are default bridge network, user-defined bridge network, and overlay network with single node. Host and Mac VLAN network drivers are doesn't work in MacBook. First let us see, list of available Docker network options, by executing Docker network ls command. We can see there are three default Docker's network options available. Now let us list out available container images in my Docker host. Now I'm going to start my first container, that is backend application. For demo purpose I've created one container image. With the help of this container image, we can execute some data structure algorithms using REST API calls. Here, I'm giving container name as DS with Java, and 9090 is host port and 8080 is container port, and the image name is data structures with Java. I've created this container image while I was demonstrating Docker container creation topic. Now the container is up and running, and if you notice the above Docker run command, I've not specified any network option, so Docker daemon attaches default bridge network for this container. Now let us start the second container as well, without any network option, so that both the containers can communicate with each other, by using internal virtual IP addresses created by Docker's bridge software. And I'm using curl container image to start the second container. With this container we can execute curl post calls to back-end container, that is our first container, which is up and running on port 9090. Before that let us find the first container virtual IP address, so that the second container can hit first one with its IP address. Here I'm using Docker network inspect command to find the IP address. Now I'm going to run the second container as well. It made a calls to first container successfully and we can see the response from first container. Now, we'll start both the containers again, but this time we'll attach user-defined bridge network to both the containers using network option. Before that we have to create user-defined bridge network, using Docker network create CLI option. Here I'm using driver option to define the driver type. Driver option is optional for bridge networks. Now I'm starting the same container again with user-defined bridge network option. This is one of the major benefit from user-defined bridge network, and you can attach and detach user-defined bridge network to a container at runtime. Even for this container bridge network creates virtual IP address. We can see container is up and running. Let us start the second container as well, that is curl container, which can make a curl call to backend container. This time we need not to look for internal IP address. The curl container can hit directly to other container by referring container's service name, and if you notice the highlighted information, where I'm referring container service name instead of virtual IP address. I'm going to remove the user-defined bridge network by executing Docker network room command. Now let us test overlay network. It doesn't work as expected in MacBook, because it is multi-host network option, which runs on top of host-specific network rules, but we can give a try with single-node swarm service in MacBook. I'm going to execute Docker nodes command, to verify whether I've executed Docker swarm in it or not, because this command works only on Docker swarm nodes. By using Docker Swarm service we can create a Docker native cluster, which means adding set of Docker hosts into a single group, in which node you execute Docker Swarm in it, that node is going to be leader node, to add any node to group then weave to execute Docker Swarm join command with write token, and make sure required ports are open, to establish the connectivity. And if you notice, two additional networks got added to network stack. A bridge network called Docker Gateway Bridge, which connects the individual Docker daemon, other one an overlay network called Ingress, which handles the control and data traffic related to swarm services. Now I'm going to create new overlay network by using overlay driver, with attachable option. I'm going to start the same backend container again with overlay test network. Application is up and running. Let us inspect the overlay test network, to verify list of connected containers and those virtual IP addresses, and overlay driver created different gateway and subnet for the backend container when compare with bridge network. It created as per its default behavior, but we can configure range of IP addresses at time of network creation. Let us run the second container as well, by attaching overlay test network, and it should able to hit the backend container, with container name. As both the container are referring same overlay network, container can reach other container port directly without referring any host port. In the video description, you can find all reference document links. If you feel that you learned something from this video, then please subscribe to this channel for more knowledge sharing sessions.